Yeah, De'Aaron, you've been beat up the last couple of games. You even got a eye issue tonight. Just what did it take to sort of come up big there in the fourth quarter and finish this one off?
I think there's always a chance that I could, you know, go on a run. So that is what it is. You just keep with it. But for us, I wouldn't say that's why we won the game. I think we were able to get key stops. We were able to execute down the stretch, and I think that's what ultimately won us this game. And we also had a big lead that we gave away, but we were able to maintain the lead throughout the entire. I don't think we ever lost it in the second half. So it was good that we were able to answer their run.
You guys gave up obviously a lot of offensive rebounds to them. To be able to overcome some of that, even you know when you guys aren't maybe executing as well as you'd like, how big is that to do, especially down the stretch there?
Well, it's great that we were winning at the time, so that's always a big thing. But we just have to be better at boxing out. I mean, that is what it is. That could have lost us a game, but like I said, at the end of the day, we were able to execute at the end of the day. So that is that.
Hey, D'Aaron. So everybody says scoring the fourth quarter is hard, but you got 15 tonight, and you're the most efficient player on the clutch time in this league. I just want to know, how do you make this looks like easy?
I told RJ in the fourth quarter, shots just seem to go in, so I'm not doing anything different. They tell me the same thing. I'm like, sometimes the shots just start going in more, so that is that. I don't think there's a better way to put it.
Malik, I know first quarter and better first half defense has been a focal point for this team, but to hold New York to 23 points in that first quarter, how big was that for the team tonight?
Yeah, it was huge, man. The first unit started off right and got the big lead, man. We just came in and kept the pressure up in the first half. So we just got to continue to do that. But like Fox said, we got to box out, man. We got to box out.
Want to see what you guys both thought about just being on a stage where you know they're watching you nationally. Did you get extra excited about it, or did it matter to the team? And did you feel like you guys had to make a statement knowing that more people are watching you perhaps than they have all season?
Well, at this point, it seems like we only play New York teams on TV, so shit. It is big. But at the end of the day, I mean, once we get to the playoffs, every game is going to be like that anyway. So I don't think we were worried about it. The timeouts are longer. Warm-up sometimes, the clock went from, I think, like 18 to 25. So you got to make sure things are on schedule. But that's pretty much the only difference I feel like we see.
Yeah, I ain't see a difference, man. We've been locked in from the beginning of the year, so.
De'Aaron, obviously your fourth quarter numbers have been up there amongst the leaders in the league all year. But for the team perspective, you guys have been one of the best fourth quarter teams in the NBA for most of the season. What's been key to that, maybe aside from your individual performances?
I think as a team, obviously we're whatever the offense rating is, and we're at the top of the league in scoring. But I feel like offensively we could play many different ways. We can just go pick and roll. We can get into isolations, we can get into post-ups, we can still throw the ball through the elbow and have guys split. There's just many different ways that we can attack teams, obviously all throughout the game, but in the fourth quarter. And I think whenever we keep our pace up, and not just trying to get on the break, but in the half court with guys moving, I think it's hard to guard. I think it's hard to guard multiple actions, or if someone has it going, getting them the ball, or if it's an isolation, or if it's a post-up, or Domas, or HB, whatever it may be, there's just so many different ways that we can attack people offensively.
Malik, you guys survived 23 offensive rebounds. I know you guys were talking about that, but how did you do it? I mean, you came together and pulled out the win.
Yeah, man, that's a good question. The big lead I think we got in the first half is why we stayed in the game and pulled out with it. That's a lot of offensive rebounds, man.
Josh Hart had eight.
Yeah, eight of them. Yeah, he was killing us all night, man. It's hard to win a basketball game like that, man, and I'm thankful we won it.
Malik, you've seen all season long Fox put up big numbers in the fourth. What do you just make of it as someone who knows him so well to see him kind of shine in that type of moment?
I'll be trying to get him going earlier than that. he don't listen sometimes, but it's Fox, man. I've been seeing it for almost all my life, man. I know what he's gonna do. I know how to say something to get him turned on too. So,
whoa,
come on,
whoa,
oh my God,
and jeez, and Fox, what did you when you got obviously. When you got going, obviously, there later in the fourth, you were chirping a little bit. It even looked like over towards their bench. Are you able to kind of share what maybe some of the things you were saying?
I was talking to Q when he was on the bench. Q is one of my guys. He's from Houston, so that's someone that I saw and watched while we were growing up and playing against and playing with. So I was just talking to Q. That's all it was.
Yeah, I was going to just comment about, like, I don't think I've ever seen you talk this much mess out on the court. How much fun are you having?
I mean, when it gets going, and it's a close game, I think it gets intense, and I was on a roll at that point. Like I said, there's always at any point in the game, I feel like he can too. When Kev, Domas, HB, we've seen HB do it. Keegan, someone can just get it rolling in a heartbeat, and that's all that happened right there.
Fox, you've spoken many times about wanting to be the guy to help bring playoffs back here and bring this crowd back into playoff basketball. I know the crowd has been there all season long, but to experience that tonight, the energy, and have the national audience see that, what does that mean to you?
I think it's big for the organization and for the city. I mean, this is much bigger than us. Like you said, I think people know about the Sacramento crowd, but obviously we play late games. People on the East Coast or in Central Time aren't, you know, they're asleep when we're playing. So for them to be able to experience, and obviously not everybody has league pass. So for people to experience this on TNT tonight, I think was huge for this fan base and for this organization. And I think once playoff time comes, obviously most all arenas are loud, but I think this is just a special place to play.
You were talking earlier, basically saying once we get in the playoffs and even right there, just, you know, when playoff time comes, when did it become, when did it flip in your mind from, like, you know, the organizational goal is to make the playoffs to now? I mean, it's obviously a pretty confident franchise that it's happening.
I mean, just for what we've been able to do throughout the season, what Mike's come here and what he said, I mean, even before the season started, he's instilled confidence in us, and hell, he might make you believe that you're better than you are. That is what it is. So every night we go out there, we expect to win. Obviously, we go out there, we play hard, we try to execute. And we know you're not going to win every game, but you go out expecting to win. You go out and you do whatever it takes to win. And I feel like we've done a good job at that, even in some games that we've lost. Sometimes a team is just better that night. So for us, it's just we continue to worry about us. We continue to worry about what we do. We try to get better. And like I said, I think everybody wants to win a championship.
Yeah, Malik, how much confidence do you have late in games when you've seen him do what he's done in fourth quarters?
How much confidence I have in me or him?
In you guys pulling it out.
Oh, man, I wouldn't have came here if I didn't have confidence in the team from the get-go. So I knew the pieces. I knew what this could be. And I knew what he could do. So everybody just feeds off him, Domas, Kev, HB. So, yeah, man, we're just confident in everybody. And Mike, like he said, Mike installed that in us.
Malik first and then De'Aaron, if you guys don't mind. To the question about this, like making statements, I mean, how much do you enjoy the opportunity to play on this kind of a stage? And what does it say about you that you've risen to the occasion now a couple times?
Oh, yeah, man, like he said, it's always great to finally show the Sacramento crowd to the world or the U.S. or whoever watching, especially how loud it gets to here, man. So it's always great. It's just always great.
Yeah, I mean, like I said, I think people know about it, but for them to just be able to turn on their TV and not have to go through League Pass to watch it, I think was definitely the big thing. And like I said, during the playoffs, you know, it's going to be a normal occurrence. So hopefully we're able to get home court advantage and those first two games just get rocking.